Good morning, owls. Are we ready to talk about some animals that live in the ocean? Good, I hope so. So, we've been talking about the letter I. Remember, I says I, or I. But we're also talking about animals that live in the ocean. So I wrote some words down here, and I thought it would be a good idea for you guys to maybe think of your favorite animal that lives in the ocean, and you can write out the word and draw a picture. I know you guys can do that. So let's take a look at what Miss Benham wrote. I wrote swordfish, octopus, whale, eel, and lobster. All of these animals live in the ocean. So let's take a look down here at lobster. When we spell lobster, it's L-O-B-S-T-E-R. And a lobster is maybe about the size of your computer, and it has big claws that go like this. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Eel. E-E-L. An eel is kind of like an underwater snake. That's pretty much how you think about it. Whale. W-H-A-L-E. Whale. A whale is a big animal that lives in the ocean. And it has a hole on top of its head. And when it comes up a little bit above the water or below the water, it spouts the water right out of that hole. I know, isn't that cool? We have octopus. O-C-T-O-P-U-S. And we're going to read a story a little bit later today about an octopus. And an octopus has 8 legs. Can you imagine having 8 legs? I'm kind of happy with just having 2. Yeah. And swordfish. S-W-O-R-D-F-I-S-H. Swordfish. Now, I have something really cool to show you. But first, I want to show you what a swordfish looks like. This is a swordfish, okay? It's a big fish that lives in the ocean, and it has a very long, hard nose, and it looks just like a sword. Now, do you want to see what the sword actually looks like? Hold on. Now, I'm going to tell you a really cool story. My great-grandfather owned a big boat, and it's called a schooner. And do you know what he did? His job was to go out fishing. And one day, when he was in his dinghy with his first mate, that's a little boat that they keep on the schooner for when the crew need to go out to go fishing with their nets, because it's kind of hard to do it on that really big boat, okay? So he was out in the dinghy with his first mate when, do you know what happened? A swordfish came up through the bottom of the boat, and it put a hole in the bottom of the boat. And so my great-grandfather told his first mate to hold on to the sword, and he sawed it off. And he kept that sword, and he held on to it, and they quickly rowed back to the schooner, and they quickly got back up, keeping the sword in the boat so it didn't sink, because that would not have been a good thing to happen. And he took a piece of wood, and he carved it, and he made a handle. So I'm going to show you what it looks like. Hold on a second, guys. Let me get it. All right, now this, okay, this is very old. This has been a part of Miss Benden's family for over 100 years. This right here is an actual sword of the swordfish. Isn't this huge? And this is only a part of the swordfish. Now, I want you to look down here. See the tip, it broke off when Miss Benden moved at one point. But it just came out just a little bit further, maybe right there. And it's very sharp, and you have to be careful. So this has been polished. But this is the actual sword of a swordfish. And my great-grandfather, he took a piece of driftwood, and he carved the handle here and he attached it. So if you look, you can see there are two little screws in here and they are keeping the handle onto the sword part. So I thought you guys would like to see this. So this right here is the actual part of a swordfish. And I showed you that a swordfish looks just like this. And this is the part that I was showing you right here, this long part. Isn't that cool? All right, owls, I want you to try to write about your favorite animal that lives in the ocean, and maybe you can draw a picture of it. So I wrote down swordfish because I have this sword and I thought you guys would really like to see that. Okay, owls, I hope you had fun talking about some animals that live in the ocean. Bye.